weekly feed. I'm Kyle Meredith. Sitting next to me, you probably recognize the great Gary Clark Jr.
Ooh, great.
The great.
Ooh. Woo.
You know, I don't have to say it. It's already bestowed upon you. You came out swinging the fences, and suddenly there was the great Gary Clark Jr.
Oh, man.
Like, I know there was a lot of stuff said in the press and everything that, you know, it's like, oh, he's, you know, he is this and that and this. But I think it's you that you have to live up to at this point, because Black and Blue, what a fantastic record.
Thanks.
And suddenly it's like, that's the bar.
Oh man, what? Is it over? Oh hell.
No. We got faith in you.
No, yeah, I'm definitely, I got some new ideas and I'm excited. The last couple of years have been great with Black and Blue. And you know, I'm working on something to raise the bar even more, especially when you say that, you put that pressure on me. I'm like, man, come on.
So like, you can thank me in the liners on that one. No. So what is, I mean, you did, there were so many sounds going on this. Are you still searching, for what you can do, how you can manipulate?
Always.
What you do? I
mean, always. That's the beauty of music for me is, you know, people may beg to differ and for certain reasons and people have their opinions, but that's why I got involved in music and everything that makes noise is because really the possibilities are endless.
Yeah.
And I love to get in there and create and experiment and explore and just try and test myself.
Yeah.
And see what I can come up with. And to be quite honest, a lot of it I will never let anybody hear because it just shouldn't be heard. But at least I went there, you know what I mean?
Sure.
I took that chance, and that's what I love about it. So yeah.
You say that stretch. Now, but in 30 years when we're doing deluxe anniversary editions, and somebody's demanding you hit the archives.
Yeah.
It's like that's the stuff that's left.
Yeah. Well, we'll see.
Yeah. Yeah. So tell me about this, because it's not that just Black and Blue happened, because you got a mixtape out.
Yeah.
What was the mindset behind that? Why did you say, you know what, this is a great idea?
Well, the thing was I didn't have any features on Black and Blue. I didn't have any guests, really. It was something that I wanted to just express on my own, you know, first one out of the gate. I wanted to see if I could stand on my own feet. And but then at the same time, I was thinking, oh, well, it'd be cool to have other artists collab on it. And what a perfect opportunity, the idea, you know, of having these artists interpret what I've done and put their own take on it. You know, it's like a nice gift to me as well, you know, to have these great artists kind of take it and flip it and express how they feel on these tracks and, you know, make it a new thing.
Did you have a big wish list? Was there like a master list of saying, oh, this person would be great?
A master wish list? I'm a big fan of Big Crit. I met him a couple of years ago and we talked about doing something together. So the possibility of him working on it came up. And like, yeah, so we put that together and he did his thing on it, which I think is amazing.
Yeah.
Great producer, you know, and Alice Smith, absolutely love what Alice Smith does. You know, her whole vibe and her voice is incredible. So she's been singing at me, please come home at my shows. She'll come by and she's saying, sing my song, Gary, sing my song. And I can hear her and I was like, you know, let's just make this official and put it on record.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Talib Kweli.
Right?
Yeah.
It's a great moment off of it.
Bilal, Robert Glasper. Yeah, good stuff.
Well, I you know, I've got my own wish list now after I heard this, and I started thinking, well, Gary Clark Jr.'s got a lot of influence in the hip-hop world. Maybe he can get Outkast to make the record and not just a reunion tour.
Oh, man.
That's what I want to see happen.
That's what, do you think I can do?
No, I think if you get them both on and you guys do the thing together, that's my wish list. I you know, starting to call that out.
Yeah, I wouldn't be mad at that.
Yeah.
I'll just like stalk them down. Around Outkast, where are you?
Right.
Let's do this.
There was a few years ago, I got to do an interview with you at South By, and we were talking about the greatest living guitarist, and you mentioned Prince.
Yeah.
Yeah, as the greatest. And now you're label mates again. Like, he's back with Warner Brothers.
Yeah, doing it.
Can that happen?
I don't know if that can happen. That's not really up to me at this point.
Yeah.
Prince is Prince, and I got mad respect for him.
Yeah.
Greatest guitar player, musician, songwriter, vibe, just like It's Prince.
And even the new stuff is good.
Yeah, I love it.
Like, I started wondering years ago about certain artists, like, how can they sustain that type of musicianship? You know, a lot of people have their golden era of their career. Right. Not saying the stuff after or before is bad, but they have, but you have people like that.
Right.
You know? It's nuts.
I think it's just some people are just born to just be awesome all the time. I don't know.
Again, we like to put that stuff on YouTube.
Yeah.
So you're doing good stuff. I know you have spent a lot of time almost, I don't know if it was meticulous, but like tearing down your image so you wouldn't be pigeonholed. You know?
No, I was never tearing down anything. I'd always been, you know, ever since I was really young, I've been doing all kinds of stuff. And, you know, it's like a perception and who I roll with, you know, things start to be said. And I'm like, oh, this kid's going to do this, or this kid's going to do that. And I've just been playing music. You can call it what you want.
Yeah,
right. It's up to you to call it what you want. But I wanted to just make sure, coming from me, I'm just a music lover. Loves to play music. Yeah. I love to pick up my guitar or whatever and just see what happens.
Have you been working with any co-writes or anything? Like actually writing with other people? Because guesting is one thing, but have you worked with actually like creating and writing?
No, I haven't. Yeah. Not really. I did a little bit of writing on Black and Blue with Doyle Bramhall II, yeah. Mike Elizondo, and Ali Tamposi, which was cool. But not really. I just kind of tune into a channel and let it flow and yeah. Work it out and yeah. See what happens. I probably should, otherwise I think I'm being a little bit selfish, but in due time, man, pressure.
I'm not implying anything by that one, obviously. I see a lot of times, you know, once an artist gets out there finally and the world's paying attention, then those doors seem to happen a little bit more. Like, you get you get to play with your heroes, you can write with your heroes,
right.
You know, and then it becomes an interesting process. Like, here, you know, you have a style of writing that suddenly you're sharing, you know, doing a little dance with someone else.
Right. I'm still a bit protective.
You're guarded. Yeah.
I don't know. It's what my problem is. I should probably get over that. In due time.
In due time. So as far as due time, is there an ETA on, you know, maybe when the next record is going to start or finish or anything?
I would be lying to you if I said I knew when.
So no clue. No clue.
I'm just doing it. Right, hopefully soon, because I'm ready. I got to get this out. And, share it. Yeah.
Well, we can't wait to hear it, dude. Gary Clark Jr.
Hang out
fast. Yeah, thanks so much for dropping by, dude.
Thank you.
We'll see you soon.
Cool.